Hey, it's Rich, the Louisiana Hobby Guy. Today we're going to be talking about a problem that I see a lot online. And a lot of people run into this problem, which is the laser stopping in the middle of a job. Let me show you one of the causes that it could possibly be. So here I've got this image on my screen here. And I'm going to move this to the top left corner, like that. And you would think that you could engrave this because all of this image is now on the work area. None of it is off to the side of the work area, as you can see. And that is absolutely not true, because if we double click on this image over here on the cuts and layers, you're gonna see that we have overscanning turned on. If you have a diode laser, you need to have your overscanning turned on. And what that means is that the laser has to go beyond the size of the image in order to scan. So let me set this to millimeters up here. And then the way I like to set up my machine, if I go to the gear icon up top, I have it set with a visual grid spacing of 1 millimeter. So we're going to use that visual grid spacing. We're going to double click the image over here on cuts and layers. And we're going to come over here and look at the overscanning number. So I have in here, by default, for the LaserMATIC 10, it is 4% from the factory. That's what they recommend. And that tells me that it is 1 millimeter overscanned beyond the boundary of the image itself. So whatever number you set here, if I set this to 3, it's 3/4 of a millimeter overscanned. And you can get away with 3 on the LaserMATIC 10. So I'm going to leave that at 3. It's 0.75 millimeters we now know is the overscan. So now if we zoom in really close here, I have 1 millimeter spacing. There's no way that the laser is going to be able to do this. It's going to hit the rail on the left side and stop. Now it may start the job. Let's take a look and see. Let's go back to the beginning and look. It's going to start this job and it's going to run this job just fine, because everything is on the workbed until we get to there, right there. Right there, the job is going to stop because there's no extra space for it to overscan. And that's going to be the end of your job. It's going to stop right in the middle of it. So all we have to do is select it, zoom in a little bit, and just compensate for that. I'm going to hold control, and I'm going to press my right arrow key, and I'm going to move it out, and you see how that went out 1 millimeter. So now the overscan is right up to here, and we have a little bit of room left over there, but we don't have enough space on top. That's only about a 0.5 millimeter. So I'm going to hold control again and use my down arrow, and now we're in a complete safe zone, because it's 3/4 of a millimeter is the red zone up here. So we're at 1.5 millimeters right there. We're at 1.25 millimeters over here. But this job is now ready to run. And you will not hit a hard stop, and it will not stop in the middle of the job. And there are lots of reasons why lasers stop in the middle of the job. It could be a USB that goes to sleep. I mean, there are several reasons why it'll stop. But this is one of the most common reasons that drives people absolutely crazy. And if you're using a CO2 laser, you have an even much bigger safe zone, because the CO2 is going to travel that much faster. It needs a whole lot more area for the overscanning. Now, you don't have the overscan setting in your cuts and layers on the CO2. It's built into your Rurita controller or your Trosin controller or whatever controller you have on your CO2. But this is specifically for the diode laser. So I wanted to make just a quick short video today. I know I'm not famous for those, but this is a common problem. I've answered this question twice successfully this week, so I thought that maybe I should tell you about it so you can protect yourself from running into this error. So I hope you enjoyed this video today as much as I enjoyed making it for you. And as always, I want to thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.